cover crops, just like the name is, they are crops that you grow to cover the soil in periods where usually nothing is growing. So what people do, especially in the Midwest, where you grow a lot of corn and soybean, is after the harvest of the corn and soybean, the soil is usually left bare between October and the next growing season, sometime in April. And usually sometime around this time, you get a lot of rainfall. So the idea of cover crop is to have something growing on the field around this period to protect the soil, to prevent soil erosion. That's what cover crops are. So they are not really grown for their economic benefits, but they are grown just to provide a lot of conservation benefits to the soil and also to the environment. Now, how they help prevent extreme soil temperature change is by increasing soil moisture content within the soil. So that if you have high soil moisture content, the heat transport is significantly reduced so that the soil temperature doesn't change as quickly or as drastically as you expect it to change. During the fall, during the winter season when nothing is growing, that is when you can plant the cover crops. So you can, and the good thing with cover crops is there are different types of cover crops. You can plant two or three different cover crops growing on the field at the same time. So it doesn't have to be one of them, say cereal rye. It doesn't have to be only cereal rye. You can also plant hairy vetch or Austrian winter pea and have all of them grow together, because all of them provide different things within the soil. Some of them are even able to fix atmospheric nitrogen into the soil. That way, the farmer can save extra money that's supposed to be spent buying nitrogen fertilizer. So that's another beneficial influence of having cover crops on the field.